I guess I was the remix engineer, so it's going back to the original tapes and deciding how we're going to approach remixing this stuff. So the first thing was to decide kind of what speed we were going to work stuff at, because there's quite significant speed differences between the mono and the stereo mixes. So we decided the mono was the original, the original and the band's version of the mixes. So again, okay, we've got to transfer all the tapes at the right speed to do that. So then we've got everything digitized in the computer, and then it's kind of how do we approach remixing this stuff. So it's just really listening to and like appraising the mixes that have been done before, the mono mix, the stereo mix, and working out what we think's good about it, and all the effects that are used and all that kind of stuff. And then just trying to incorporate the best bits of all of that. Yeah, really happy. I think, when you're working on this stuff, you don't want to change anything. You've got to have a good reason to change anything, you know what I mean? Because people know it and they love it and it's great. So, every kind of decision is considered. But, I think it's come out really well. Retains the essence of the album that people know and love, but hopefully just sounds a little bit more contemporary, a little bit more punchy. When we're talking about remixing this stuff, we're going back to the original tapes and looking at what's there for us to use, really. So the Beatles were recording here, in Studio 2, and they were recording on 1-inch tape. So it's tape which has got 4 tracks on it. So they'd be going, right, let's put down a rhythm track of something. So they'd start maybe like drums, guitar, 2 guitars, piano, that kind of stuff. Work out the structure of the song and how it goes. And then they get that rhythm track down, that'd go on track 1. And then it's, what do we add, the overdubs. So then it might be, bass was always overdubbed on Sgt. Pepper because Paul wanted time to, kind of work on the bass away from the pressures of everyone else playing. So bass is always separate. And then other overdubs, guitars, and whether they're doing like the clarinet arrangement stuff on When I'm 64, or the horns on Good Morning, that kind of thing. So once they'd filled up all 4 tracks on a tape machine, they'd then bounce those 4 tracks onto 1 track of another tape machine, and they'd do this process again, keep adding more and more layers. So in Sgt. Pepper, they often did this 3 or 4 times. So there's sort of 4 tapes with all the elements on. So we've got all these in the vault here. So we can go back and transfer all these tapes, all perfectly synchronized. So then we can get to all the individual instruments that were recorded separately. So this is kind of what we can work with to do the remixes from. We get all that stuff into a computer at high resolution, and then we sort of start mixing. And then it's just listening to the original mixes. And the first thing we do is copy the original mix, so we get everything sounding exactly the same as it did originally. And then we kind of think, well, how could we make this better, or sound more contemporary? So whether it's looking at the kind of the stereo picture, a lot of stuff on these 60s stereo mixes are like all the vocals might be on one side and all the drums on the other side, which kind of sounds cool, but sounds a bit odd to our kind of contemporary ear. We're used to a stereo picture with a vocal in the center and all that stuff. So we're kind of going, how can we make this work in a more contemporary way? So that's kind of the process. And it's just finding the best way to do it and make it sound the best. And sometimes that's using old vintage gear. And sometimes that's using, brand new plugins and computer technology, but just whatever works to make it sound good, really. Yeah, definitely do feel pressure doing this stuff, because it's not like it's going to be released and no one's going to hear it, And you feel pressure because people around the world know this music and they love this music. It's got that resonant thing, that emotional connection to, the Beatles, probably more than anyone else in the world of music. So you feel a massive pressure not to, not to fuck that thing up that people love. It's like, if it's not, we're trying to make it better, better, not change the music, but make the listening experience better without taking away any of that. What is the essence of this music that makes it great and people love it? So yeah, you do feel the pressure. It's a collaboration. So we'll normally kind of sit down and get the sort of basic ideas of what we want to try and achieve, just talking about it. And then I'll go away and kind of start working on stuff and get a mix together and something that I think works well. And then Giles will come in sort of fresh and listen to it. And he's really good at that sort of, even though he knows it all so well, he'll come in and sort of be objective and go, okay, I'm listening to this for the first time. You know, how do that emotional reaction thing again, how does it, you know, does it have the character of the original? Do I prefer the sonics of it? All that kind of stuff. And he's good at having that sort of objective opinion. And then, yeah, we just argue about whether the drum should be louder or, you know what I mean? that's kind of the process. I think just because it is a bit bizarre and it is a bit unusual, and the sort of the sequence of tracks, there's no two tracks that are similar on the record, and some of those kind of juxtapositions, like between, you go from within you, without you, or you're in this world of this Indian music that totally draws you in, and then there's a really quick kind of cut, especially for the 60s, you know, quick, and then you're straight into When I'm 64, and it's just so kind of jarring, but really works well. So I think it's just the contrast of stuff that's on the record. It's so brave and it still sounds kind of fresh now. In fact, you know, I think we've got a long way back away from that really now, because people, you know, think of a record as being a sort of a cohesive whole where you get sound and you don't want to mix it up too much. But I think a record like this proves that, you know, the more diverse you are within that format, if you do it right, it can be really effective. Do I have a favourite track? I don't know. I guess it'd have to be Down the Life. That's just a kind of a song without equals, really. The kind of scale of it. That was definitely one of the hardest tracks to remix. It's that character thing again. It's got, you know, these kind of simple but reflective verses into sort of epic orchestral things. And we found that was a hard thing, because when you changed even a small element in that, then the song didn't seem the same. So that was when we kept coming back to again and again, going, that doesn't quite work, we've lost something here. So some tracks came together really easily on the album, like something like Getting Better. I think that just, we found that quite easy to make a big sonic improvement on it, because it was all there in the multi-track. But something like Down the Life is quite simple, it's only a couple of tracks. It's a tricky one to do, but I hope it's come out well, and sounds good.